Welcome. How can I help you today? Okay, yeah, I can definitely help you with that. Well, as I guess you can kind of tell, we're not sort of a regular doll store. We have pretty unique pieces. Usually we don't have doubles of things. A lot of the stuff is donated, or things that we find in like thrift stores or estate sales, eBay, you know, things like that. So it's just a sort of collection of a bunch of unique dolls. Yeah. I know it can be kind of overwhelming walking through the store by yourself, but if you would like, I can show you some dolls if you'd be interested. Okay, that's great. So I'm just gonna pick a few and share with you a couple different varieties. I can choose some like that, definitely. Alright, so, I'm just gonna go grab a few dolls if you don't mind. Okay, so I've got a couple selections. I know, you saw me running around the store. I was very excited about this. Usually people just come in and wander around, but, it is part of my training to be able to curate a good selection of dolls to share with customers. So I'm glad I get to put that training to the test. Yes. So let's just get started. Okay. So the first doll that I have here today, this sort of prairie looking doll. She's quite tall. Yes. So she is handmade. She was found at an estate sale. And she does not have a face, no. if you want to give her a face, you definitely can, but honestly, I think having no face gives her more character. Yes, so I will show you. That's just her head, basically. And she has this, it is not tight enough, so I will tighten it for you real quick so that you can see properly. But she has, it can fold. This sort of hat, bonnet situation, and it can come off of her. It just ties off. And she's got this matching apron to go over her clothes. So she has this beautiful cornflower blue shirt with wildflowers all over it, and her pants the same pattern. Yes. And she has shoes, basically. They don't come off, it's just a part of her. This is the first doll. I really love her, honestly. She's seems to radiate a very special kind of energy. So Here's the first doll. I will set her down. Right here. Okay. So the next, since we do have a lot of these types and people tend to come in here looking for this kind of doll, is this Beanie Baby. I do not know if it is a real, you know, TY tie Beanie Baby. There is no tag, but if you can hear, if you listen like really closely. Yeah, there's that sort of acrylic bead inside of it that you find in a lot of dolls from the 2000s. But it's just this very cute little mouse. It's a very sweet face and very big pink ears. And he has a plastic nose and plastic eyes and a string for his mouth. Then he's kind of floppy, yeah. Perfect for like a toddler, I would say. These are always good dolls for toddlers. Has a nice tail, I think. Made out of a fleece, soft fleece material. You can feel it, yeah, definitely. Yeah. So, this is the next doll. Very cute, very sweet. Okay. So, the next one is kind of a rare item. I know the first one is definitely rare because it's handmade, one of a kind, but this one is more of a collector's item from the 80s. So, and it's very loved, very worn. So if you know how to restore dolls and clean them, then you can definitely do that as long as you're, you know, safe with the process. But I think it's okay to buy dolls that are very well loved, because sometimes, you know, environments can't really help that. But this is a raccoon from the Care Bears. So if you don't know, Care Bears do more, at least they used to do more than just the classic bears that we all know. And they ventured out and did like raccoons and other animals. I think there's a lion as well. I can try and see what their name is. It is Bright Heart Raccoon, Care Bear Cousins Collection from 1984. So, they have. Since it's Bright Heart, if you can see, their heart pattern is actually a light bulb, which is really cute. And they have like their tongue sticking out and a little heart nose. And then these plastic eyes. Cute little ears. And I think is a really adorable touch is this synthetic hair on top. It's just one little string. But they also have this big stripy raccoon tail. Yes. So this is the Bright Heart Raccoon. Definitely a collector's item if you collect vintage Care Bears. So, on theme with Care Bears, kind of, we have this sort of classic teddy bear. again. Very well loved. But a little cleaner than the other one. So, he has this nice, very soft, golden fur. Very cute ears. Again, the sort of acrylic eyes and nose. And this one is, I think it's more of an, no, it's still a string. Still a string mouth, rather than embroidered. So he's kind of little, kind of just fits. A nice size, I think. Very, huggable. Yeah. And he's got a very tiny tail. The tag is worn out, so there's nothing, not really any information on it, but it's just sort of classic teddy bear. I don't think it's vintage. I think at most it's early 2000s, I would say. Yeah. So, that is just this teddy bear. And next, we have another sort of one-of-a-kind doll. It's handcrafted. It's actually crocheted, I believe. So we have this beautiful poodle. So she's a very long face, very floppy ears, and she has rather than a classic pink poodle look, she has a very soft rose kind of color scheme going on. And she's got brown nose and brown eyes, and she has long arms, and if you can see on the inside, there is fluff. Yeah, so that is what she's filled with, is just the generic fluff that you find at your local craft store. She has these arms, but she she just kind of very sleepy, I think. So, she doesn't have any legs. Yeah. But she does come with this sweet little nightgown that I think went to like another baby doll. I don't think that it was made for her. So yeah, it is this cute little white nightgown with her, if you are interested. I think she's very sweet, very unique, yeah, and definitely, I would say a collector's item if you collect poodles. So, the last one I have is on the bigger side, around the size of the raccoon. So, it is this bunny. Well, not giant, but definitely like a nice hugging size, I think. So, let me try and find. Yeah, the tag is all worn out as well. It tends to happen that sort of material is not long lasting in terms of being washed. Yeah. So, she has a very, it's not rough, but it's not too soft either. I think it's a really nice texture. And she has these acrylic eyes. And then her mouth is sort of shaped that way rather than it being a string like the other dolls. She She has these very big ears as well that stay back. And she sits like this, as you can see. And she has this nice big fluffy tail. So yeah, she's also not very squishable, I think. But it's like a nice firm squish. Yeah. So that is the last item I have picked. It has a sort of idea of the things that we carry. Yeah. I'm so glad that you like that one. Yeah, I can, if you would like, I can grab a couple of other dolls that are similar, and we can take a look at those and see if you want multiple or if you like one above all the others. Yeah, okay, just sit tight, enjoy these dolls while I go grab a couple more to show you.